My name is Kevin Delaney. I've been showing off the magic of science for years. Everywhere from museums to late night talk shows. Science is all around us, and I want the world to see it. So I'm combining everyday elements in ways that will blow your mind. I've got a team of experts and high-tech cameras that will reveal the science that surrounds us in ways you've never seen before. I'm taking science to the streets. This is Street Science. I'm back on the streets and looking for fun places to break out my chemistry skills. I know salons have a stockpile of chemicals I could use to make something huge. And what fun would that be without my slow-mo expert, Darren Dyke, to capture the magic as only he can?
How long has it been?
Couple years, yeah. Keeps growing.
It sure does. That's the one thing that keeps us in business.
It's true. So what chemicals do y'all use here?
So we use hair color.
Okay.
Relaxing products. Hydrogen peroxide. It's my friend.
I like hydrogen peroxide, too. You want to see something fun with hydrogen peroxide?
Yeah.
All right. I love hydrogen peroxide. It bubbles like this when it chemically reacts to bacteria, in effect, burning off the pathogens. This is why hydrogen peroxide makes the perfect antiseptic.
Oh, y'all ready?
Yeah!
Annalisa, you want to help me out with this one?
Yeah, let's go. Right, let's do this.
Woo! The hydrogen peroxide, if it gets on your skin, it'll kind of like bleach it a little bit. So nobody touch it once you see whatever you see. So should we go with soap next?
Yeah, let's do soap.
All right.
Okay. Here we go.
Mix it around a little bit. This is food coloring and hydrogen peroxide. And now, we're gonna add our catalyst,
potassium iodide.
Which is also used in hair treatments, photography, and for a variety of medical uses. Potassium iodide, like most catalysts, is just a normal chemical that will speed up certain reactants that find each other attractive. It's basically chemical speed dating with the catalyst playing the role of Cupid.
Everybody stand back.
Right.
Uh-oh. Annalisa,
okay.
Are you ready?
You ready?
Three, two, one.
This particular demonstration is often referred to as elephant toothpaste because of the elephant-sized foam accumulation that resembles toothpaste being squeezed out of a tube. What's going on here is an exothermic reaction. An exothermic reaction is a molecular change that releases energy by light or heat.
That's
crazy.
You
can see the smoke coming
off
it. It keeps going.
So that's an exothermic reaction, so it's gonna release heat along with all that energy.
Oh.
Don't touch it. And don't eat it. I can't emphasize that enough. Please don't eat this foam.
Oh my goodness, that's wild.
What's the chemical symbol for water? Anybody know?
H2O.
H2O. What's the chemical symbol for hydrogen peroxide?
H2O2.
H2O2. So we have a lot of oxygen in there. So when we catalyze that oxygen by putting that potassium iodide in, we release all that oxygen really, really rapidly, and all that soap gets really bubbly and creates a ton of foam.
So that looks crazy. I think that looks absolutely insane. But I think we could definitely make that look a lot crazier.
Yeah.
What would we have to do to make that fill up a car?
Well, it depends on the car. We'd have to get a dumb little car that was almost perfectly round, like a volumetric flask.
All right.
And then we could, like, turn it into a flask.
I gotcha.
And then we could find out some way to get the catalyst in, and maybe it would work.
Let's do this thing.
We hit the junkyard to give this old car a second life. What it lacks in engine parts, I'll make up for by filling it up with 140 bottles of heavy-duty hydrogen peroxide and 4.5 gallons of dish soap. We're also adding food coloring to give our car a colorful hairdo.
Sorry, dude. You're gonna have to take the brunt of this one.
Then, my slow-mo expert, Darren, loads it up with an obnoxious number of cameras to record the action and show you the science you can't see with the naked eye.
All right, Darren, you wanted a car? We've got a car.
Dude, this looks like Frankenstein gone wrong.
Well, he was the doctor.
I'm really interested in seeing those two dummies in there just getting pasted.
Hey, that's a rude word. They're mannequins. And they're handsome mannequins.
True that.
What's going on, man? What are you planning?
I'll be trying to focus on just the spout.
All right,
hopefully,
cool.
We'll see something dramatic.
All right, man, now's the time. You ready?
Let's do it.
All right. So what we've seen today so far, we call demonstration. So when we're demonstrating a scientific concept, we already know what's gonna happen. There's not really any surprise to it. But this, this is an experiment. We don't know what's gonna happen. We've never tried this
before. Never done it before?
We don't know that anybody's ever tried it before. So I need some predictions. What do y'all think is gonna happen here?
I think this car's gonna shoot out that way and 60 miles an hour.
60 miles an hour.
And 5 seconds.
I like your idea, Zora. Yeah. What other predictions do we have? Anybody else?
Foam is just gonna just ooze out of this thing everywhere.
All right, we've got about 140 bottles. That's 70 liters of hydrogen peroxide in the car. We've got our catalyst that's gonna pour down through here. We've got a couple of mannequins inside.
Yeah, who's in there?
Just a couple of dudes.
They look like you.
I guess so.
What are they putting in right now?
So that's our catalyst. That's our potassium iodide, a big bucket full of it. Chris, you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, guys. 3, 2, 1. We came to a salon, so we thought we'd give you a nice do for this little car. Yeah, right on.
That was wild.
Darren is using a FLIR thermal cam so we can see all the heat being produced from the chemical reaction. FLIR stands for forward-looking infrared. The camera detects infrared energy, also known as heat. Each color represents different temperatures. In this case, red is the hottest and represents 190 degrees Fahrenheit.
When it shoots up, it's crazy how dramatic the difference is. It looks almost like lava, and it has a very similar way that it kind of folds over. It looks really cool.
Just like people use foam containers to keep food warm, this foam is insulating the hydrogen peroxide chemical reaction, maintaining its heat.
That was crazy, that was awesome. And the slow motion just looks super good.
Discovery.